everyone. As I strive to live mindfully, learning how to be a mindful consumer really shapes what I buy, how I buy, and when I buy items. Today, I'm sharing my intentional shopping habits. When I began living minimally over 13 years ago, I realized that it's very unrealistic to think that I would never buy anything ever again. What I needed to do was to practice mindful consumerism and adopt healthy habits around my money and shopping. When I think about my old shopping habits, I'm really surprised by them. I used to have this kind of overwhelming need to shop and purchase and collect more things. I would always buy new things for my home, even though I didn't need them, more clothes. Even though my closet was already packed, I could not resist cute little outfits for my girls or my son. Sometimes I would shop out of boredom. Sometimes I would shop because I felt the need to keep up with the Joneses. Maybe sometimes I shopped to fill a void. There was lots of reasons why I had unhealthy shopping habits. I did not know how to be a mindful consumer, and I didn't have healthy, intentional shopping habits. I don't impulse buy anymore, and when I do find myself needing to buy something, I follow these really simple mindful consumer habits. I have refined these intentional shopping habits throughout many years, and I hope that they will be as fulfilling for you as they are for me. Wish list. I don't impulse buy, but when I do need something, I will put it down on a wish list. This really helps me create a plan for the items that I need to purchase in the future. This helps eliminate impulse buys. 24-hour pause. It's easy to get caught up in the excitement of a sale or even in the adrenaline rush of buying something new. If I do find myself in a situation where I'm tempted to impulsively buy something that's not on my list, I'll give it 24 hours. I will leave it in the store or in my cart if I'm shopping online. And after 24 hours, if I've thought about it and I still really want the item, then I'll go ahead and purchase it. The whole cost. Looking at what this item is actually going to cost me, not just financially, but in my other resources like time and energy. What is the whole cost of this purchase? Is this purchase worth as much as I'm giving away to get it? If I choose to buy a skirt for $40, that's $40 that I could have used toward bills or groceries. I could have put it in savings or into an investment. It takes time to shop, and time is a valuable commodity that we don't have much of. It's time I could have used visiting with a friend, catching up on housework, or even doing a yoga practice. Time, money, and energy are valuable resources that I have limited amounts of. By identifying what I value most and then spending my energy in these areas, it has impacted my life tremendously. What value do I get? Asking myself this question of what do I get when I purchase this item? If my vacuum cleaner is broken, then by purchasing a new vacuum, I get a clean floor. A planner contributes to my life because in this way I can organize my life and be efficient. As a minimalist, I sometimes get caught up in just the value and usefulness out of something, but there's also just the value of joy. I love fresh flowers, and so for me, I gain a ton of value just out of the joy that the fresh flowers bring me. What are some of your minimalist shopping habits that you found really benefit you? If you guys enjoy this video and mindful living, please, I ask you to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. It really helps my channel grow. Thank you. Use it up. Waste not, want not, I think is the quote, but using up all of what I do have. I have clothes that I've had for over 10 years. My TV was a hand-me-down given to me over 10 years ago, and I plan on using it till it doesn't work anymore. We drive a 12-year-old car that we bought used, and we're really good about just maintaining it and keeping it in good running condition. Research. When I need something new, I will do my research on it. I will read reviews. I will make sure it's the best possible price that I can get for it. And whenever possible, I shop at small local businesses, boutiques, fresh markets. Let it go. When I am decluttering my house, I let go of the things that no longer serve me. Before I choose to buy something new, I ask myself, will I be able to get the most use out of this item in its lifetime? And if I can, then I'm happy to make the purchase. Sometimes I choose to let go of that item before I've even purchased it and brought it into my home. There is no right or wrong way to live a minimalist lifestyle. Minimalism is shaped and designed around your unique lifestyle and what brings you the most joy. I hope you've enjoyed this video today and that it's given you some ideas on how to be a mindful consumer. If you've enjoyed this video, I ask you to please click subscribe and give it a thumbs up and maybe check out some of these other videos around me on mindful living. Thanks.